So yesterday, Sayadaw-ji expounded the faith and confidence to develop in the Dhammayana River teacher and his instruction and guidance. So it is very important to have faith and confidence in the teachers and his guideline. Like a medicine. So throughout samsara, cycle of birth and death, the become lying dormant in our mental process. So to cure such a disease, the dhamma, the medicine or dhamma is very important. And then the correct treatment is necessary. So as a patient, he or she need to have faith and confidence in the physician, doctor, and his correct treatment. So and as a physician, he also need to make a suitable medicine, collecting the necessary ingredients so that it can meet the purpose. So in this way, this faith and confidence in the teacher and his guidance is necessary and beneficial to the followers. So and then another important factor is the encouragement from a Dhammayana River person. So if you are encouraged by an admirable person to do something, you feel encouraged to do something. So somebody who out of compassion with the purpose to serve your welfare, encourage you to do the wholesome thing. Such a person is admired by the people around. So such person is called in Pali Sambhavaniya, the admirable person. So that person must have good moral conduct, and he must be good-hearted, and also must have wisdom and knowledge. And the encouragement from that person is one of the main factors, one of the main causes of your faith and confidence in the Dhamma. So in old days, the Brahma, the superior celestial being, is highly respected by the people. So such a highly respected Brahma kneeled down to the Buddha and humbly requested to give Dhamma. Then people all over the world, they increase, arouse faith and confidence in the Buddha and his Dhamma. So such a request and encouragement is very important to arouse your faith and confidence. Now, Sayadaw-ji want to explain further in detail for your general knowledge something about that. So regarding the highly respected superior celestial being, Brahma, Sayadaw-ji now explains about the Atta or Atma in Sanskrit, or soul, maybe in English. So in the Hindu scriptures, the regarding Atta or Atma or soul, they explain in very detail. The Atta is honored or described as a Jnanadhikarana Mata. That means all wisdom and knowledge depend on the Atta or soul. The derived from the atta or soul. So wisdom itself is defined as a atta. That atta is of two kinds, jiva atta and brahma atta, so mentioned in those texts. So jiva atta means the individual soul or self or ego. So brahma atta means the universal soul or ego, which govern the whole universe, just like mighty God. So out of two kinds of atta souls, the Parama Atta is described the controller of the whole universe. He governs the whole universe. So everybody on earth follows his will. According to his will, one supposed to reborn or die. So it is one of the virtues or quality or that the Parama Atta or soul. So in Pali it's called Iswa. Iswa means the universal governor, universal controller. And also that Parama Atta is honored as a sub-venue, the omniscient. He is the omniscient, he knows everything. And another virtue is Ekovas, that is unique. He is the only one in the universe, no two. And also he determines our happiness and unhappiness. And also he has no form, no solid form, he is formless. So these are all descriptions of the Parama Atta, universal soul. So second kind of Atta is a Jiva Atta, individual soul, which is described Patisera. It's subject to all individual living beings in the world. So that jiva atta, individual soul, derives from the Parama Atta, the universal soul. So that jiva atta split into each and every individual in the universe, from the small insects until the trees and plants. Another description is Perino. Is can be the individual atta is different in size. So according to the individual person, for example, the ants, the small, so that his atta is small. The elephant is huge, big, and then his atta also huge, big. According to the individual. But the atta can be big and small in size. So this can be compared to a rubber band, which can be straightened as much as you want. So the atta, the individual soul, also can be different in size according to the individual living beings. So another quality is a vibhu. Vibhu means is remarkably powerful. Is powerful to some extent. The jiva atta, the individual soul is. We are able to see or hear, smell, taste or touch. So our senses are determined by that jiva or life or the soul. Without that jiva atta, it's not possible to see or hear and so on. So all our senses are governed by or determined by the jiva anda. So that we that reject the law of cause and effect, mind and body, and they are causality and relativity. So another description is nature means everlasting. So jiva anda is never die, everlast. So the that jiva anda, individual soul derived from the universal soul, so everlasting, never dying. Although this physical body is destroyed, that anda, that soul is lasting. It shifts to another new physical body. Or if he follow the jiva anda's will or wish until the satisfactory state, then he will be, or that jiva anda will be saved or taken to the heaven. So this type of view had been deep-seated in the people's hearts long before the Buddhas appeared. So they believe Parama Anda, Iswa, and Jiva Anda, individual soul. So when the Buddhas appeared, so the Buddha rejects the Anda or soul. So the Buddha proclaimed there is only mental and physical phenomena, they are causality and relativity. There is no anda or ego or self or soul involved in the process of the mind and body. So the Buddha denied that there is anda or ego. Only mind and body arise and pass away. So that's the Buddha's revolutionized the atta view of the atta view, and then the Buddha established anatta vada, the anatta view. So as a anatta believer, so how this life take place, come into existence, who created this life? It is karma. So karma creates this life. If we have done the good karma, then we can have the good life. So best karma can result in that life. So these are all the cause and effect. Only the dharma, mental and physical phenomena, they are causality. That's all. No more, no less. For example, so you are listening to the Dhamma talk, you hear the voice or the Sayaraji. So that voice from Sayaraji strike your eardrum, and then you pay attention to that, and you hearing consciousness take place. So there is which one is Adha and Adha? The ear, is ear Adha or soul? No, ear also a type of physical phenomena. And how about the voice? It's also the physical phenomena. No Brahma or no God who create that sound. Actually, sound is created by the mind, or sometimes it's the nature because of the wind or air, it makes sound, noise. So the sound or noise, they take place according to the law of cause and effect, they take place naturally. So no one creates sound, no anda. So here there is ear, song and attention, the strike and you pay attention, then hearing consciousness take place. That's all mental and physical phenomena. No ego or no ada involved in that mental and physical process. So it's very clear. There is no ada involved in the mental and physical process. So the ada believer, they think, they hear with the help of the soul or ego. Actually, there is an ear, and that's a physical phenomena. And also voice or sound, that's also a physical phenomena. And no ada or ego is there. And hearing consciousness take place when the sound strikes the eardrum. When you pay attention to the sound, then hearing consciousness take place. That's the law of cause and effect. No ada or ego or soul involved in that process. All are mental and physical phenomena. So the way they believe or the way they talk are actually just imaginary, just imagination, not the truth. So at the moment of hearing, for example, if there is no ear, to hearing consciousness or hearing cannot take place. Or divide of sound, if there is no sound coming into your ear, and then you cannot hear. Hearing consciousness cannot take place by any means. Or if you don't pay attention to the sound, then also no way for you to hear. So there are conditions to be met, then hearing consciousness take place. If there are any conditions is short, so the any person or any universal atta cannot create hearing or hearing consciousness. If any of factor is solid. So if there is all conditions are met, I mean the sound, ear, and attention, and hearing consciousness take place. No universal ada or no mighty God cannot stop that hearing consciousness from arising. So hearing consciousness definitely take place if the conditions are met. So there is no room for the individual soul or universal soul or ada. There is no role or part to play for them. Only mental and physical phenomena, they are causal and related, that's all. So the belief in jiva ada, out of the two kinds of ada, can be overcome or can be reduced to some extent when you see, when you are able to distinguish between mind and body, mental and physical phenomena, by observing then the moment they take place. But to uproot, to eradicate that the wrong view, you must be practiced. You must practice until you become sotapanna, until you attain the first stage of enlightenment. So to overcome the wrong view of the parama anda, the individual soul, when you practice vipassana meditation and see the causality, the law of cause and effect, then you can realize the true nature or the law of cause and effect, then you can overcome the wrong view or the Paramahansa universe. So, but of course, you can root out only when you become Sotapanna, you attain the first stage of enlightenment. So if you believe in another, if you have the view of another, you are regarded the Buddha's follower. So when you practice Satipatthana meditation, you will be able to see the true phenomena of mind and body, and then their causality and relativity. Then you will be able to believe the anatta. Then only can you be regarded as a Buddha's disciple. And also you need to believe the karma and its good and bad results. The other believer nowadays Hindu people, they believe in karma too. And at the same time they believe in the creator, the Brahma. So they believe the Brahma created the world, and karma also determine our lives. They believe so. So they are someone like that, sitting on the fence. They sit on the fence. They have two confused beliefs. For Christian people, they purely believe only on the Creator, the Mighty God. So all the living beings all the living beings are at the mercy of the God. So we are all determined and governed by the God. We are all at the mercy of the God. So that's the Christianity. So the other believer, they believe the universal soul or the Brahma that provides all living beings with whatever they need. So that's the only belief, imagination. So according to their belief, they don't need to do anything. They don't need to do anything to lift up the quality of their life. They don't need to do anything for purifying their mind or to get rid of mental defilement. So all they need to do is just to believe in the God. That's all. So if they don't have any practice or any worldwide practice, there's no way for them to enjoy the worldwide benefit. So as another believer, they don't believe in Brahma or God. They believe themselves. They have self-confidence. They follow, they understand the correct instruction given by the Buddha. They accept and then they follow. They can enjoy the benefits. So in old days, people totally believe in Brahma. So such a highly respected Brahma came down and humbly requested the Buddhas to give Dhamma talk. So that's very encouraging for those people to believe or to have confidence in the Buddhas and his talk. So thus they start to learn the teaching of the Buddha. That's me, okaha, learning. They start to become curious what his teaching, how, why, and what the sadha faith means. Something like this. They become curious and they start learning on the Buddha. And then after that, they discuss among them So in this way they are learning in Pali Puka, and after that they take discussion the Pariposa. So based on the faith. So thus they become they start learning and they become curious of the Buddha. So they know that who is the teacher. So Satta is the teacher. The teacher who carry out the welfare of the people or living beings. And out of compassion he gave instruction and guidance. So they believe the good teacher and then the Dhamma, his instruction. So Tathā means here the teacher, right teacher, and the Dhamma means his instruction. So they become interested in the teacher and his instruction. Then they increase the faith and the confidence in the teacher, and they learn from him, and then they put their learning into practice. And then thus, again, in turn, the faith and the confidence in the teacher and his instruction increase. So in this way, the teacher and his instruction and the faith in them, they mutually conducive to each other. So, following the instruction, the guidance, Dhamma, you can increase the faith and confidence and the teacher and his talk. And then, thus you can purify your mental and physical and bodily behavior. So, first of all, you need to learn the correct method. Now here you are learning correct method. So you are interested in the Satipatthana meditation. How remarkable Satipatthana meditation is, how beneficial the practice is. And when you are able to see the benefits of the Satipatthana meditation, you will develop the faith and confidence and practice in the teacher. So in this way, the learning is very conducive to your practice. So that learning is called the in Pali Savana. And first of all, you learn, and then you keep it in mind and put it into practice. That stage is called Dharana. So there are also several want to explain further tomorrow. That's all for today. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.